Friends, in this session, we are ready to discuss relationship between Cartesian and spherical coordinate system, that is transformation between xyz and r theta phi. As shown in figure, we consider point P with Cartesian coordinates xyz, cylindrical coordinates rho phi z and spherical coordinates r theta phi. The representation of Cartesian coordinates is very simple. Here, z is called height with respect to z axis. And after projecting point P onto xy plane, taking z equals to 0, we get x coordinate with respect to x axis and y coordinate with respect to y axis. Now we represent spherical coordinates, that is r theta phi. Here phi angle is same as cylindrical coordinate system which is represented on xy plane. So angle phi is made by radius of a cylinder rho with respect to x axis. Here radius rho is equals to OB, which makes an angle phi with respect to x-axis. Next, in spherical coordinate system, angle theta is always represented with respect to z-axis. And it is made by small r, that is called radius of the sphere. So it is concluded that angle phi is made by rho with respect to x-axis and angle theta is made by small r with respect to z-axis. Now, for relationship, we consider right angle triangle OAB and OCP. So, first we consider right angle triangle OAB, that is on xy plane. Here, OA equals to x, AB equals to y and OB equals to rho. And radius rho makes an angle phi with respect to x. So, using right angle triangle and trigonometric concepts, x equals to rho cos phi, y equals to rho sin phi, and angle phi can be determined using tan inverse of y upon x. Also, we can write rho equals to under root of x square plus y square. Similarly, we take second right angle triangle OCP. Here, OC equals to z, CP equals to rho, OP equals to r, and angle theta is made by radius r with respect to z axis. So, we can write z equals to r cos theta, rho equals to r sin theta, and angle theta equals to tan inverse of rho upon z. Also, in place of r, we can write under root of rho square plus z square. So, using these relationship, if Cartesian coordinates are given, that is xyz, we can determine spherical coordinates r theta phi or vice versa. Now, in order to get relationship between xyz and r theta phi, we can put rho equals to under root of x square plus y square. So the spherical coordinate system becomes r equals to under root of x square plus y square plus z square. Theta equals to tan inverse under root of x square plus y square upon z. And phi equals to tan inverse of y upon x. Similarly, for Cartesian coordinates, we can put rho equals to r sin theta, which results x equals to r sin theta cos phi, y equals to r sin theta sin phi, and z equals to r cos theta. After this, we can also relate unit vectors corresponding to Cartesian and spherical coordinate system. Unit vectors in Cartesian system are unit vector x, unit vector y, and unit vector z. And in spherical coordinate system, unit vectors are ar, a theta, a phi. Now first, we consider differential length in spherical coordinate system, that is r theta phi, and it is denoted by dl vector equals to dr unit vector r plus r d theta unit vector theta plus r sin theta d phi unit vector phi. And from here, we have to find unit vector r, unit vector theta and unit vector phi. So first, we have to find unit vector r. Here we consider theta and phi as a constant, which results d theta equals to d phi equals to 0. And after putting d theta d phi equals to 0 in differential length equation, we get dl vector equals to dr unit vector r. So unit vector r becomes dl vector upon dr. Next, to find unit vector theta, we consider r and phi as a constant, which means dr equals to d phi equals to 0. And after putting dr d phi equals to 0 in dl vector, it results r d theta unit vector theta. So, unit vector theta equals to dl vector upon r d theta. Similarly, for unit vector phi, we consider r and theta as a constant and it results dr d theta equals to 0. So, in this case, dl vector becomes r sin theta d phi unit vector phi. And after rearrangement, unit vector phi equals to dl vector upon r sine theta d phi. Now, in order to derive relationship of unit vector r, unit vector theta, unit vector phi with respect to unit vectors in Cartesian coordinate system, we consider dl vector in Cartesian coordinate system and it is equals to dx unit vector x plus dy unit vector y plus dz unit vector z. Now, using unit vector r equals to dl vector upon dr, which is obtained after consider d theta d phi equals to 0, as theta and phi consider as a constant. So, we put dl vector of Cartesian coordinate system and we get unit vector r equals to dx upon dr unit vector x plus dy upon dr unit vector y plus dz upon dr unit vector z. Next, we have to find values of dx upon dr, dy upon dr and dz upon dr. According to the formula, x equals to r sin theta cos phi, y equals to r sin theta sin phi and z equals to r cos theta, which shows a relation between Cartesian and spherical coordinate system. So, to find dx upon dr, we differentiate x equals to r sin theta cos phi and it gives dx equals to dr sin theta cos phi because here theta and phi are the constant. So, dx upon dr becomes sin theta into cos phi. Similarly, we get dy upon dr equals to sin theta sin phi and dz upon dr equals to cos theta. And after putting these values in unit vector r, we get unit vector r equals to sin theta cos phi unit vector x plus sin theta sin phi unit vector y plus cos theta unit vector z. So next, we have to find unit vector theta. Here, r and phi act as a constant, so dr and d phi equals to 0. And after putting dl vector of Cartesian coordinate system, we get unit vector theta equals to dx upon r d theta unit vector x plus dy upon r d theta unit vector y plus dz upon r d theta unit vector z. And our purpose is to find dx upon r d theta, dy upon r d theta and dz upon r d theta. For this, we again use formula x equals to r sin theta cos phi, y equals to r sin theta sin phi and z equals to r cos theta. Here we consider r and phi as a constant, so its differential value become dx equals to r cos phi cos theta d theta because differential of sin theta equals to cos theta while other terms are constant. Similarly, dy becomes r sin phi cos phi d theta and dz equals to minus r sin theta d theta. So we can say that dx upon r d theta equals to cos theta cos phi, dy upon r d theta equals to cos theta sin phi and dz upon r d theta equals to minus sin theta. And after putting these values, we get unit vector theta equals to cos theta cos phi unit vector x plus cos theta sin phi unit vector y minus sin theta unit vector z. At last, we have to find unit vector phi, which is equals to dl vector upon r sin theta d phi. Here r and theta are the constants, so dr equals to d theta equals to 0. So after putting dl vector of Cartesian coordinate system, we get unit vector phi equals to dx upon r sin theta d phi unit vector x, dy upon r sin theta d phi unit vector y plus dz upon r sin theta d phi unit vector z. And here we have to find dx upon r sin theta d phi, dy upon r sin theta d phi and dz upon r sin theta d phi, that is a magnitude terms. So this can be obtained using formula x equals to r sin theta cos phi, y equals to r sin theta sin phi and z equals to r cos theta, as these are the relationship between Cartesian and spherical coordinate system. So in a first case, differential value of dx, which is minus r sin theta sin phi d phi. Here r and theta are considered as a constant. So, differentiation of cos phi is minus sin phi. And after rearrangement, we get dx upon r sin theta d phi equals to minus sin phi. Similarly, we get dy equals to r sin theta cos phi d phi. And this results dy upon r sin theta d phi equals to cos phi. And in case of dz, we get 0 because here r and theta are the only constants. So we can write dz upon r sin theta d phi equals to 0. Now after putting all these values in the unit vector phi, we get unit vector phi equals to minus sin phi unit vector x plus cos phi unit vector y. Now we can represent unit vectors or spherical coordinate system in matrix form, that is in terms of Cartesian coordinate system. So at the left side we make a column matrix, unit vector r, unit vector theta, unit vector phi, and in the right side there is a product of square matrix and column matrix. In square matrix, first row having magnitude component corresponding to unit vector ar, that is sin theta cos phi, sin theta sin phi and cos theta. Second row have cos theta cos phi, cos theta sin phi and minus sin theta corresponding to unit vector theta. And the third row have magnitude component of minus sin phi, cos phi 0. At the right side, this square matrix is multiplied by a column matrix, that is unit vector x, unit vector y and unit vector z. Also, this matrix representation can be written in terms of unit vector x, unit vector y, unit vector z. In this case, we take inverse of square matrix, which means the rows and columns of the square matrix are interchanged. Next, this matrix relation can also be written in terms of vector components. For example, in case of vector in spherical coordinate system, there are magnitude component as ar, a theta and a phi and represent in left side as column matrix. And in 3x3 square matrix, we can write a dot product of corresponding unit vectors. Here, in the first row, we can write unit vector r dot unit vector x, unit vector r dot unit vector y, and unit vector r dot unit vector z. Here, the value of unit vector r dot unit vector x is sin theta cos phi, unit vector r dot unit vector y is sin theta sin phi, and unit vector r dot unit vector z is cos theta. Similarly, we can write second and third row accordingly. Here also, we can write vector component matrix in terms of ax, ay and az. And the corresponding value of dot product is given same as square matrix.